Students, in today's session, we'll be learning about uninvolved parenting style, example of uninvolved parenting style, and summary of it. So, at the end of this session, you'll be able to discuss the uninvolved parenting style, list the characteristics of children raised by uninvolved parents. Students, as we are discussing about parenting style, and there are different parenting style, and according to Borman, the fourth type of parenting style is uninvolved parenting style. Looking at this word itself, we can make out that uninvolvement of parent, which means that parents are not actively involved with the child. Look at this example. Here is a poor child who is asking something to the mother, and mother is saying, "No, right now I'm very busy." So the mother is not paying attention what the child is asking for. So parents who belong to uninvolved parenting style, they are generally very ambivalent to their child's wants and need. That's why they are considered as uninvolved parents. So let's see the features of uninvolved parenting style. The first one is, there is no demand, there are no rules. So what does it mean? The parents don't expect anything from their child. At the same time, they don't set any rules for the child. No communication. There is no sort of communication with the child. So they don't interact with the child. So no parent-child, child-parent communication takes place. As there is no communication, there is no encouragement. So parents are not involved in encouraging the child during the milestones of the child development. So what does it mean? It means that psychologically as well as physically, parents are unavailable for their children. So if parents are unavailable for their children, that leads to lot of problems that affects the development of the child, which means that the development of the child is negatively affected. According to Garbarino and Abramowitz, 1992, what did they say? They said that their unmet psychological needs make them vulnerable to being easily discouraged by everyday problems and turns the child away from full and satisfying participation in the world. So what does this definition say? This definition says that because parents are not available for the child, so that leads to unfulfillment of their needs, which has to be satisfied by the parents, and they become very vulnerable because parents don't provide any support, and later on the child will not be able to cope up with their day-to-day problem, which will lead the child very unsatisfied, and they won't be able to contribute in the world. As a result of which, their social development gets hindered, they have a very low self-esteem, and even their self-concept, which has to be positive, that also gets affected. So let's summarize what we have learnt about uninvolved parents. First point is, emotionally they are away from their children. They don't have any or very few expectations from their children, and many of time intentionally they avoid their children. So student, this lack of communication between parent and child not only affect the social development of the child, it also affects the cognitive development of the child, because parents are not there to provide nurturing environment to the child. So this is not considered to be a very good, rather I'll say it is not a good parenting style. Students, so far we have talked about four types of parenting style given by Borman, that is authoritarian, authoritative, permissive, uninvolved parenting style. So look at this picture, and we are going to talk about in terms of demandingness and responsiveness with respect to these four parenting style. When it comes to authoritative parenting style, they are high in demand. That means they also have expectation from their child. At the same time, their responsiveness also is high, which means they give full cooperation to the child. They satisfy the needs of the child. When it comes to authoritarian parenting style, they are very high in terms of demandingness. It means they expect a lot from the child. But when it comes to responsiveness, they are very low in that. Now, third type, permissive type. When it comes to demand, they are very low. It means they don't demand anything from their child. But when it comes to responsiveness, that is nurturing aspect, they are very high in that, which means they are very good in that. When it comes to the last, which is uninvolved, indifferent parenting style, they are low in demand as well as they are low in responsiveness, which means they don't demand anything. At the same time, they don't have any responsiveness also for their kids. So students, different parenting styles lead to different child outcomes. And out of these, you must have realized that authoritative style is linked to positive behavior, which leads to strong self-esteem as well as self-competence. Other factor which plays a very important role in parenting style is the culture. At the same time, the children's perception of parental treatment. How do they perceive their parental treatment to them? Even social influences play a significant role in children's behavior. Look at this image. This image gives you the overview of the entire session, which talks about the characteristics of each parenting style. At the same time, how control and warmth is in proportion to high and low. Thank you, students.